Hey guys, hope you all are doing good. This is Amo. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel. This is a speed test between the Huawei Mate 20 Pro and the Google Pixel 3 XL. This battle is taking place between the 7nm Kirin 980 and the 10nm Snapdragon 845. The ultimate competition is happening between a RAM of 6GB and 4GB. The involved GPUs are Mali G76 MP10 and the Adreno 630. This is also a very good chance to see how the EMUI stands against a pure stock Android. First up, we have the Mate 20 Pro, and here are its complete specifications. And then we have the Pixel 3 XL. Take a look at its spec sheet here. So guys, without wasting a further minute, let's start the speed test now. So guys, let's begin with the speed test on the Huawei Mate 20 Pro and the Google Pixel 3 XL. First of all, I'm going to turn on both the devices to see which one boots faster. Here we go. The phones are now turning on. Let's see which one boots up before the other one. And here we have the Google Pixel 3 XL has already booted up and the Mate 20 Pro is still booting up. In the meanwhile, let's take a look at the screen unlock options. We have the rear fingerprint scanner on the Pixel 3 XL and the under display fingerprint scanner on the Huawei Mate 20 Pro. Now that the Huawei Mate 20 Pro has booted up as well, we are going to try the fingerprint scanners on both the devices. Let's see which one unlocks the phone faster. So it looks a similar result first, and let's see once again. It looks like the Huawei Mate 20 Pro is doing a better job here. Or it might be similar. Okay guys, so you decide which one boots up faster. Let's go ahead with the application speed test. First up, we have absolutely nothing open on both the devices. And in the very first time, we are going to launch some stock applications. First of all, we have phone application. Phone loads on Mate 20 Pro faster. And let's see the next application we have here. It's the messaging application on both the phones. Pixel 3 XL wins the messaging application. And we have the camera application, Mate 20 Pro it is. Let's try launching the settings application on both the devices. And here the Mate 20 Pro wins once again. So out of 4, Mate 20 Pro wins for 3 applications. Let's try launching some third party applications. First of all, we have Instagram. Let's see. Mate 20 Pro wins on Instagram as well. Let's try launching Facebook application now. Mate 20 Pro on Facebook. Messenger. Mate 20 Pro on Messenger as well, I believe. Snapchat. Mate 20 Pro on Snapchat as well. Next up we have Twitter. Mate 20 Pro on Twitter as well. And we have the Google Plus here. Google Pixel wins for Google Plus. Let's try launching the Google Maps application. Mate 20 Pro wins for Map as well. Let's see Reddit. Pixel 3 XL for Reddit. Let's try launching the AliExpress application. Pixel 3 XL for AliExpress. Let's see Gmail. Mate 20 Pro for Gmail. Let's try the Play Store on both the phones. Mate 20 Pro wins for Google Play Store as well. Let's see what happens with YouTube now. Mate 20 Pro wins for YouTube as well. Let's see the result on Snapseed. Here I'm going to try editing a picture, and the phone that edits the picture earlier and finishes earlier is going to be the winner. So let's try applying a filter on a random picture and exporting it to the gallery. It's time to export this picture now. I will press save on both the devices at the same time. So the Mate 20 Pro finishes a lot earlier than the Google Pixel 3 XL. Let's try launching Lightroom now and Mate 20 Pro does an incredible job once again. VLC media player. Mate 20 Pro once again. We have Netflix. Pixel 3 XL nails the Netflix speed test. Let's try launching the Microsoft Word application. Mate 20 Pro once again. Let's try launching the Google Chrome and try browsing some websites. First up, I will close all the applications, all the websites, and now we will launch the website here. Let's see how Huawei.com loads on both the phones. Mate 20 Pro loads Huawei faster than the Pixel 3 XL. Wikipedia loads on the Mate 20 Pro faster as well. So guys, it's time to launch some games. First up, we have the Subway Surfers game. Let's see how it performs. Subway Surfers loads on the Mate 20 Pro faster. Let's see how Temple Run 2 loads on both the devices. Mate 20 Pro takes a clear lead here once again. It looks like Pixel 3 XL is not coming along really well, and this phone is going to bite the dust of defeat in the end. Let's try launching S4 9, which is a heavier game, in order to see which phone performs better on this game. So Pixel 3 XL does a better job while loading the S4 9 game. I will close the S4 9 and go ahead with PUBG Mobile on both the devices. So let's see which phone loads PUBG Mobile faster. Here we go. It looks like Mate 20 Pro is ahead once again, and Mate 20 Pro is going to win the PUBG Mobile speed test as well. Yes, Mate 20 Pro is ahead, and Mate 20 Pro aces the PUBG Mobile test as well. So guys, it's time to go through all the applications once again in order to see the multitasking and RAM management on both the devices. Here you can see that I have all the applications still open in the RAM of all the phones. So I'm going to relaunch all these applications, not all these, in fact some of these applications, one by one once again to see which one is still there in the memory. So Mate 20 Pro loaded the Instagram application in a much better way. For Facebook, Mate 20 Pro wins once again. And for the next application, we have Twitter. Mate 20 Pro wins once again. It loaded the Twitter from the same instance. And Google Plus, Mate 20 Pro once again. Let's try launching another application, Reddit. Subway Surfers. Both phones are loading this game from scratch, which is not a good sign. It should have been there in the memory of the phones. So let's try launching Temple Run 2 now to see which phone still has it in the memory. Temple Run 2. Mate 20 Pro has loaded it while Pixel 3 XL is loading it from scratch. S4 9. So both the phones are loading S4 9 from scratch, which again is not a good sign for the RAM management of this kind of devices. So guys, let's go ahead and try launching the PUBG Mobile now to see which phone still has it in the memory. Let's see, launching the PUBG Mobile now. PUBG Mobile, here we go. So the Mate 20 Pro is loading PUBG Mobile from the same place while the Pixel 3 XL is reloading this game. So guys, it's time to shut down all the applications and perform the Antutu 3D speed test on both the devices. I am going to launch the Antutu 3D benchmark, and I will now launch the test as well. So guys, while watching this test, please keep in your mind that this test is not going to be very accurate. There are certain conditions that in which this test comes out as completely accurate. However, the current situation might not be the best one for this test. The test is only good enough to give you an idea of the graphic stress tolerated by both the devices. The phone that is going to finish earlier and post a high score is going to be the winner. If the phone isn't going to post a very high score, you may not consider it as good as very much of solid device. While all of you watch this Antutu 3D benchmark speed test between the Mate 20 Pro and the Google Pixel 3 XL, I'm going to sign off. I will see all of you with another video soon. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe now and stay connected. See you all.